Halloween night, right? Man, I was so pumped. The streets were decorated with pumpkins and faux spiderwebs. Kids were running around in costumes. And the chilly air smelled like candy and autumn leaves. Me and a bunch of friends, all grown but not too old for a good time, were out trick-or-treating, just goofing off and enjoying the night. So we're walking from house to house, bags getting heavy with candies and chocolates, laughing and joking around. We're just having the best time. Houses are decked out with spooky decorations, and some people really went all out with their costumes. As the night wore on, the streets started to empty, the little kids and their parents heading home, leaving the streets to the older crowd. And then I noticed this guy, dressed head to toe, like Michael Myers from those Halloween movies, mask and all. At first, I thought nothing of it. It's Halloween, right? People dress up. But then I noticed he was always, like, right behind us. Every house we went to, he was there, not saying anything, just standing there, watching us. I pointed him out to my friends, and we all laughed it off. Just someone getting into the Halloween spirit, we thought. But as the night went on, he was still there, following us, silent as the grave. My friends thought it was hilarious, but I was starting to freak out. This was beyond a joke, right? It wasn't funny anymore. He wasn't talking, wasn't asking for candy, just following. Always a few steps behind, his mask hiding any expression, his silence eerie in the night, filled with laughter and shouts. We decide to split up, thinking he'll just pick someone else to follow, or maybe finally give it up. I say goodbye to my friends and start heading home. I glance back, heart stopping as I see him still behind me. He's picked me to follow. Alone now, the streets dark and quiet. My laughter is gone, replaced by a growing panic. My steps quicken, and so do his. I start to run, heart pounding, footsteps and breathing loud in my ears as I race home. I reach my house, fumble with my keys, hands shaking, and rush inside, slamming the door shut and locking it. I'm safe. I'm home. I peek out through the curtains, heart still racing. There he is, standing across the street, just staring at my house. I call my friends, voice shaky, telling them about the guy still outside my house. They laugh, not believing me, thinking I'm just caught up in the Halloween hype. I hang up, feeling alone and scared. I don't know what to do. Then my phone rings. I answer, and it's one of my friends, still laughing. They set the whole thing up as a prank. They hired someone to dress up and follow us around. It was all a joke. They got me good, I'll admit it. Relief washes over me, mixed with lingering fear and adrenaline. I laugh too, but man, I was scared out of my mind. I can't shake that feeling, even knowing it was just a joke. The guy leaves, walking calmly down the street, leaving me in my lit-up house, heart still beating fast. That night, I lay in bed, the images of the masked man following me home playing over and over in my mind. I know it's over. I know it was a prank. But the fear lingers, making every shadow in my room suspicious, every sound outside my window ominous. I know I'll laugh about it tomorrow. I know I'll get them back next Halloween. But for tonight, I'm left with the echo of my pounding heart and the memory of the silent man following me through the dark, empty streets.